Well, the day has arrived when wedding receptions of up to 150 people are permitted to resume in New York State. That's under an announcement made by the governor nearly 2 months ago.
But despite their eagerness to resume business and the backlog of a whole lot of weddings that have been postponed, banquet halls are not yet feeling any rush whatsoever. Tonya Sides' Dave McKinley reports.
Despite what's now permitted, there does not appear to be a groundswell of couples beating a hasty path through the door of area banquet halls.
So far, right now, everything is canceled wedding-wise through May.
Bill Casale, who manages Riverworks and three other popular downtown venues, says the rules are the problem for many couples.
It does not present many realistic opportunities to have a wedding.
Rules require guests who've not been fully vaccinated to test negative before attending and to wear masks. They'd also be prohibited from sitting, eating, or drinking with people from outside their household or immediate party, and wouldn't be allowed to dance with them either. Hardly the wedding of their dreams for many couples.
A lot of them are canceling and just saying we're going to have an outdoor backyard wedding this summer without any rules, regulations. People can have fun.
Casale says it's not fun for venues either, who'd have to enforce the rules.
We're going to be saying no throughout the entire evening. No, I'm sorry, Aunt Linda can't come in. She didn't get tested. No, I'm sorry, Grandma can't walk to the bathroom without her mask on. That's just not what this business is all about.
It's also true that under the current guidelines, good help might be hard to find.
That's the hardest part, is finding enough help right now.
He says there's reasons why a typical server who might stand to make $100 or more a night might turn the work down.
And come on back and work two shifts a month, and you have to pay $65 for a rapid test before you can come into work. That's not very realistic.
Add to that the unemployment benefits they would lose. You've created a situation where going to work doesn't work, at least financially. Bottom line, he figures these tables will remain empty until the pandemic weakens or the state further relaxes its rules.
Now, hope is not a good business plan, but unfortunately, we have no other choice but to hope that things will continue to open up and loosen up and we can continue to do business moving forward.
Dave McKinley, Channel 2 News.